I just wanted to briefly talk about trekking poles. Now, there's a bit of contention about their usefulness on the trail, and ultimately when it comes down to choosing gear, it's going to be what's most comfortable for you and what do you enjoy using and what makes you feel good. But the research does show some benefits for trekking poles. So trekking poles, when used properly in a pair, not as a one, can reduce the load on the lower body by about 25 to 30%, depending on use and, you know, trekking poles and your mechanics and everything, but we can get up to 30% reduction of load through the lower limbs. And I know a lot of people are thinking, but that's how I work out my legs. But you wouldn't have such skinny arms if you use trekking poles, because what they really do is they help you transfer your ability to move forward from being exclusively the domain of the lower body, and they help you use your back, your triceps, and your arms to propel you forward. And really what that does is it reduces lower body fatigue, which reduces injury rates, but it also allows us to maintain a more upright posture as we're walking down the track. So as packs get heavy, instead of resulting to holding our straps and slumping around like this, we can use the poles to push us into a more upright position, and we can utilize the poles to help maintain good posture even when moving uphill. So we want to use these when we can, and if we're comfortable with them, to help our posture, improve muscular recruitment, and allow us to use our upper body in addition to our lower body to move on the trail. And really, if you think about it, when we see animals out in the bush, what moves faster and more efficiently across terrain? A two-legged animal or a four-legged animal?